Thank you very much. So should I explain about cultural track in 4 or 5 minutes? It is an international organization of cultural society mostly. And we are having an annual event in Japan this year at ICU in Tokyo. And many people from various parts of Asia and also Europe, US, and Australia all enjoy. It is not just an academic conference, it's about interesting kind of event which involves many activists or students and also non-academic writers, etc. So, anyway, so if you have any questions, please ask me about culture writing. Thank you very much for inviting me to this conference. As I said last night, a little bit, I never attended Asian Studies Conference in Korea. So I've been to Korea so many times, maybe more than 20 times, but it's the first time to attend Asian Studies Conference in Korea. So I think this signal kind of a recent development of Asian dialogue, I think, in the last 20 years or so. And my point is quite shared with Kang Myung-gun's talk and also our chair, Professor Park's very concise but very important clarification about the urgent issue we need to tackle with. And so it's quite overlap with what you already said. But so my point is, because I've been working for more than 12 years in Japan, IC and Waseda University, and then I moved to Australia about 2 years ago to take up my current position as a director of the Monash Asia Institute. This move itself shows some kind of new development of Asian studies. So I think the Asian studies meaning and the approaches and the scope of so-called Asian studies has been much expanded and also reconfigured in a quite interesting moment. I still remember in the 90s, particularly, so many academics in the U.S., like Abadurai, or maybe you don't know much about this. So it's a crisis where area studies or area studies is dead or under the globalization forces. But I think in the classic sense of such, you know, studies of a clearly demarcated entity or area or nation. Such kind of study is obviously in decline. But the other kind of new kinds of Asian studies, if we still use this term, I never use Asian studies actually, studies of various issues in Asia, is I think on the rise. So this conference signals such kind of new development itself. And so my point is, I think, as I said, Asian dialogue has been not much, but slowly but significantly developed in the last 15 years. And so my point for my today's short talk is how we should develop further, go beyond some difficulty, which I think Kamin already explained quite well. And so, Asian dialogue among, for example, researchers who are located in Asian countries. So their voices about Asian societies, culture, politics, economy, etc., tend to be neglected in the so-called West-dominated Asian studies. But we have observed many kinds of inter-Asian, trans-Asian collaboration, comparative research going on. It's quite new. And also, Kang Myung-gun and myself are part of the inter-Asia cultural studies, for example. This is quite an important moment because language barrier still weighs, I think, like today, communicating English. But, we are learning much from each other's point of view. Particularly in Japan, for example, not many scholars not writing in English, so they are mostly writing in Japanese, and maybe Korea as well. There are many good local studies about Korea or Japan or Asia. But it is hard to know unless such kind of works are translated into English. So this is still a problem today as well. But I think Inter-Asia or Trans-Asia dialogue or collaboration can try to go beyond such kind of difficulty to some extent. But this is but not exclusive to anyone studies who are doing research outside Asian region. So clearly I've moved to Australia. So I'm doing research of Asia or Japan, East Asia or Trans-Asia within Australia. So my current speaking position is quite, I think, international. One of the reasons I moved to Australia is try to make this kind of Asian dialogue less exclusive. So how we can more involve the researcher working outside Asia to enhance the Asian dialogue further. Because Asian dialogue is not just among the researchers in Asia, but also research on various regions and countries, which Professor Parker already mentioned, and also dialogue between research on various shared issues, which are similarly but differently articulated in various parts of Asia. So this kind of dialogue has been, to my point, is to some extent developed in the last 10 or 15 years compared to the 80s or 70s. Another important point is this is a kind of reciprocal learning from various Asian experiences. So inter-Asian referencing is quite interesting, and we need to do more about, I think, about this. So how we can learn from each other, so from region on the similar issues, and also, of course, discipline, interdisciplinary issues will be discussed later today. This is important for the kind of deep westernized production of knowledge to learn from each other and the local language, local conceptualization. And also, for example, my only example is always like a nukokuseki, which I use in Japanese, non-nationality, non-ethnicity. And so how this kind of term is applied and developed by researchers working on Korean culture. And so it's a kind of very interesting refinement of the new kind of conceptualization, which I originated directly from Asian experience. But my point is, this is not limited to the academic knowledge production. So as Myung-Bun already mentioned as well, people are experiencing this kind of inter-Asian referencing as a mundane practice by a mediated consumption of Korean web, for example, and also mobilities, physical mobility of people, students or business people or tourism. Here and there distinction is being blurred, and it is part of the people's everyday life and experience. So this is a significant development. But the question still remains: how to go beyond the some kind of still compartmentalization going on in terms of academic studies and also in terms of people's connection. Particularly, I think coming to the point of how we go beyond the kind of nationalized citizen mode. It is very strong, kind of right of internationalism, which I call, or renationalization, if you like. How we go beyond this kind of compartmentalization, internationalization is a very urgent issue for us to tackle this. Proposal is a Trans-Asia method. So this is part of my project as well. I'm trying to promote more dialogue among Asian people in Asia, and also academics working on Asian region and various issues in Asian countries. So how we use more media and more communication is quite significant. So because so many things are shared, but this does not necessarily mean it is shared. So this is a word by the Roger Silverstone. So how do we go beyond this shareable and shared kind of a difficulty? And second one is denationalized engagement to tackle with transnational shared issues. So as Professor Park introduced about my own research, I'm now working with researchers on Korea and Taiwan and Japan about the issue of multiculturalism, migration, and also cultural diversity within or mixed races, etc. So this is a very fine finish. So but these are very, very interesting project. This is not just in the sense of detached notion of comparative, but a more engaged notion of collaborating. We are learning from each other, and also we can engage with a similar issue, but differently articulated in each society. And also, this also involved, not just a production of academic knowledge. I think, as Phil already mentioned in the Institute, there are many activities going on outside academia. So I think this is quite important. How we can go further to work with the NGO, work with the film producer, work with the governmental option in a more progressive manner to go beyond banal nationalism, internationalism. And also, how we can combine our critical knowledge with a more creative kind of practice in the mundane level. I think this is a quite challenging challenges we are facing now for each scholar to overcome. Okay, I need to think.